Welcome to our Mystery Sleep Stories channel, your sanctuary for meditation and a peaceful sleep. Immerse yourself in the soothing embrace of sleep-inducing tales, carefully crafted to transport you to mysterious lands. Let the gentle rain and serene sounds of nature accompany you on this quest for deep sleep. Say goodbye to restless nights and welcome the embrace of a restful sleep with our mystery bedtime stories. So, let the tale begin. The Shrouded Tavern. Chapter 1. The Map of Shadows. In the dense, whispering depths of Forest Hollow, Eldric and his band of merry thieves had established themselves as the scourge of wealthy travelers and unwary merchants. Their latest target had been a lavishly adorned caravan, rumored to be carrying treasures from distant lands. As dusk painted the forest in hues of gray and lavender, Eldric and his crew ambushed the caravan on a narrow forest path, where the dense canopy blotted out the sky and the air was thick with the earthy scent of moss and wet leaves. The skirmish was brief. The merchants, more accustomed to bargaining than battling, quickly surrendered. As Eldric's men gathered the spoils, Eldric himself rummaged through a splendidly decorated carriage that seemed to promise more than just gold and goods. His intuition proved correct when he discovered a hidden compartment beneath the floorboards. Inside, wrapped in oilskin to protect it from moisture, was a tattered map, its edges frayed, the parchment yellowed with age. The map was a curious artifact. Unlike the usual navigational charts used by seafarers or the detailed town plans favored by city dwellers, this one showed an intricate network of trails snaking through Forest Hollow itself, marked with symbols that were neither common cartographic icons nor any language familiar to Eldric. Most intriguingly, a large X was scrawled over a spot deep within the forest, labeled with a drawing that unmistakably represented a tavern. An oddity, given no known taverns had ever been documented in such a remote part of the woods. Eldric, a tall figure with a keen sense of adventure, eyes as sharp as his wit, immediately recognized the potential of this find. He gathered his crew around the flickering light of a campfire, the map spread out on a flat stone. "This isn't just any treasure," he announced, his voice carrying an exciting edge. "Legends speak of the Shrouded Tavern, a place said to appear only to those worthy of its secrets. It's rumored to house a relic of immense power." With a mix of tough survivalists and crafty outlaws, the gang listened carefully as Eldric drew with his finger the route indicated on the map. Their features were masks of curiosity and expectation, lit by the flickering fire. Although they were accustomed to pillaging and robbing, they were unable to resist the challenge presented by the rumored artifact. At dawn, under a sky streaked with the pink and orange of sunrise, they set out. Their journey began on a well-trodden path, but soon veered off into darker, less traveled parts of the forest, where the trees grew so close together, their branches wove a tapestry of leaves. The light dimmed, the air cooled, and every step forward raised the scent of earth and ancient wood. The forest of Forest Hollow was a living thing. It whispered in a language only the wind seemed to understand, rustling through the leaves with soft murmurs. As they delved deeper, following the cryptic signs on the map, the forest seemed to watch, the trees ancient sentinels to their passage. Occasionally, a bird would take flight, its wings beating a hasty retreat from the intruders. Or a small animal would scuttle through the underbrush, its presence merely a whisper against the foliage. The first landmark they encountered, as marked by the map, was an old bridge known among locals as the Bridge of Whispers. It was said that to cross was to offer up your secrets to the forest. Made of stone, covered in moss and ivy, the bridge arched over a babbling stream that reflected the light in dappled patterns. Eldric was the first to step onto the ancient stones, feeling the slight give under his weight, the air around him thickening with the tangible presence of history. As each member of the band set foot on the bridge, the air shimmered slightly, and a faint whispering filled their ears, like voices carried on the breeze, too low to discern the words. Eldric, ever the leader, encouraged his crew forward. "The forest tests us," he declared, his voice steady despite the eerie atmosphere. "Let it hear our resolve." Crossing the bridge was their first trial, a passage through the veils of legend into the heart of a mystery that promised to be as perilous as it was wondrous. Beyond lay the deeper shadows of Forest Hollow, where the true adventure awaited, each step guided by the enigmatic map leading them towards the legendary Shrouded Tavern. Chapter 2, The Bridge of Whispers. As Eldric and his group of robbers fled the Bridge of Whispers, the dense undergrowth of Forest Hollow appeared to close in on them, and the air was heavy with the aroma of damp earth and forgotten secrets. The route wound its way farther into the forest, barely visible through the tangle of roots and thicket of undergrowth, leading them to more secluded, darker places where the heavy canopy blocked out sunlight. The whispers from the bridge still echoed in their ears, a haunting reminder that this forest was a realm of both beauty and peril, inhabited by more than just wildlife. According to local lore, the spirits of the forest watched over it, protecting its mysteries from unworthy intruders. Eldric, however, was not deterred by superstitions, driven instead by the thrill of the unknown and the promise of untold treasures. Their next landmark, according to the mysterious map, was the ancient ruins of a watchtower, perched ominously on a high ridge overlooking a dark valley. The structure was said to have been built by a forgotten civilization, one whose knowledge of the stars and the earth had once made them the masters of these woods. Now, it stood as a crumbling beacon of ages past, its stones moss-covered, and its presence almost spectral in the shadowy light. Approaching the ruins required navigating a steep, winding path up the ridge. The ground here was treacherous, littered with loose stones and thick roots that snaked across the path like the tentacles of some subterranean creature. Every step was a test of endurance and agility for the thieves, who were more accustomed to the flatlands and the open seas than the rugged terrain of the forest. As they ascended, a dense mist began to roll in from the valley below, enveloping the path and obscuring their vision. The air grew chill, and the forest around them fell silent, as if holding its breath. Eldric paused, sensing the change, his hand resting on the hilt of his sword. He scanned the mist, his eyes narrowing as he tried to pierce the veil that seemed to have swallowed the world. It was then that they heard it, a low, mournful howl that seemed to come from all directions at once. The sound was unlike any animal Eldric had ever encountered. It was both eerie and foreboding, filled with a sorrow that was palpable. The crew stopped in their tracks, each man exchanging uneasy glances. "Just the wind," one of the thieves muttered, though his voice lacked conviction. Eldric nodded slowly, though his instincts told him otherwise. "Stay sharp," he commanded, his voice low. "This forest holds more than just wind and whispers." Continuing their climb, they finally reached the summit and the ruins of the watchtower. The structure was more imposing up close, its stones etched with runes that glowed faintly in the misty air. Eldric approached the ruins, drawn to the ancient markings. He traced his fingers over the runes, feeling a thrum of energy that seemed to pulse from the very stones. Suddenly, the air shifted, and the mist began to swirl around the tower, forming shapes that were almost human in form. The figures danced around the ruins, their movements fluid and unnaturally graceful. Eldric and his men watched in awe and apprehension as the figures solidified, revealing themselves to be spirits of the ancient guardians of the forest, their faces serene yet sad. "You seek the Shrouded Tavern," one of the spirits spoke, its voice echoing like a whisper through the trees. "But the path is fraught with dangers that test not just your courage, but your heart." Eldric stepped forward, his resolve firm. "We are prepared to face whatever trials await. Tell us what we must do." The spirits exchanged glances, and then, as if coming to a decision, they nodded. "To reach the tavern, you must first pass the trial of shadows," the spirit declared. "You must confront your deepest fears and prove your worth to the forest." With that, the spirits faded back into the mist, leaving behind a silence that was more profound than before. Eldric turned to his men, his expression determined. "We press on," he said, leading them down the ridge and into the valley where their next challenge awaited. Each man braced for the trials to come, their journey into the heart of the forest's mysteries just beginning. Chapter 3, The Enchanted Glade. After descending from the ridge where the ancient watchtower stood, Eldric and his band of thieves continued their trek through the thickening forest. The path, which had been faint at best, now all but disappeared beneath a blanket of dense ferns and overgrown underbrush. It was as if the forest itself was trying to reclaim every inch of ground, covering up the traces of human passage. As they pressed on, the canopy above grew denser, weaving a thick tapestry of leaves that barely let any sunlight through. The air was humid and filled with the scent of earth and decay, mingling with the more ethereal fragrance of wildflowers that somehow thrived in the dim light. The deeper they went, the more the forest seemed alive, pulsating with unseen energy. Suddenly, the dense forest opened up into a large glade that was strikingly different from the dark, enclosed spaces they had navigated just moments before. The glade was bathed in a soft, luminous light that seemed to emanate from the very soil. The trees around the perimeter were massive, ancient oaks and silver-barked ash trees that stood like sentinels. Their trunks were covered in luminescent moss, and vines hung like curtains from their outstretched branches. In the center of the glade was a stone circle, old as time, the stones worn and covered with bright green moss. Eldric felt a pull towards the circle, a magnetic draw that seemed to resonate with the map in his hand. The symbols on the map vibrated gently, aligning with the configuration of the stones. As the crew ventured closer, The air grew cooler, and a soft wind began to swirl around the glade, whispering through the grass and leaves. It carried with it voices, not just the rustling of the wind, but actual voices, low and melodic, singing in a language that none of them understood, but somehow felt familiar. Eldric, captivated by the song, stepped into the circle. As he did, the ground beneath him lit up with faint, ethereal lights that traced runes and symbols similar to those on the map. The crew watched in awe as the air around Eldric shimmered with a subtle glow. "This is the heart of the forest," Eldric announced, his voice filled with wonder. "The songs are the memories of the forest, its joys and sorrows, its history. We are standing in a place of power." But as magical as the scene was, there was also an element of danger. The glade was not just a place of beauty, it was a place of power and protection. The thieves noticed shadows moving at the edge of the light, forms that were neither fully material nor completely spectral. These were the guardians of the glade, creatures of the forest that protected its most sacred heart. One of the figures approached, its form coalescing from shadow into a more solid shape. It appeared as an old man, his face creased with the lines of centuries, his eyes deep pools of ancient knowledge. "You seek the Shrouded Tavern," he stated, his voice echoing slightly as if coming from a great distance. "But why should the forest reveal its secrets to you? Outsiders who take without giving." Eldric stepped forward, his resolve clear. "We seek not just the treasure of the tavern, but understanding. We will respect the forest and its secrets. We ask for guidance, not for greed." The guardian studied him for a long moment, then nodded slowly. "To reach the tavern, you must first understand the forest. Each of you must plant a seed in this circle. Care for it tonight, and if it sprouts by morning, the forest will accept you, and the path to the tavern will be revealed." Each member of the crew took a seed from a pouch the guardian offered and planted it in the soft earth of the circle. As night fell, they settled around the glade, tending to their seeds, immersed in the glow and whispers of the enchanted place. The night was long and filled with dreams, visions of the forest's past, and glimpses of its secrets, a testament to their growing connection with the land that held the key to their quest. Chapter 4, The Shrouded Tavern. Eldric and his group emerged from the ethereal glade beneath the watchful eyes of the ancient trees, just as the first rays of dawn broke through the thick canopy, signaling the start of a new day. The seeds they'd sown the previous evening had magically germinated, growing into little yet colorful saplings that were all glowing faintly with light. Their spirits were raised, and their mission was revitalized by the forest's sign of acceptance. Following the guardian's instructions, they discovered a previously undiscovered route that wound through the forest and brought them to the Shrouded Tavern, their long-desired location. As they approached the clearing where the tavern was said to stand, a dense fog began to roll in, thick and white, swallowing the sounds of the forest and cloaking everything in a ghostly silence. The air grew noticeably cooler, and a sense of anticipation mingled with unease filled the air. Then, as if parting the veils of time itself, the outline of the tavern emerged from the mist, its time-worn wooden structure covered in climbing ivy and moss, making it appear as though it had risen straight from the earth. The tavern's appearance was as enigmatic as the legends that surrounded it. Windows adorned with heavy wooden shutters looked like closed eyes, and the door, a robust oak with a wrought iron handle, seemed to wait expectantly for them. The building exuded an aura of timelessness. The wood imbued with the scent of earth and old smoke, as if it had witnessed centuries pass from its secluded vantage point in the forest. Eldric led his men to the front door, which he pushed open with a soft creak that made a faint echo in the silent room. The tavern's interior was dimly lighted by candles that created flickering shadows on the walls, lined with shelves containing antique books and objects, each of which appeared to be hiding a secret narrative. The scent of wood smoke and dried herbs filled the air, and the stone floor, worn smooth by numerous footsteps, added to the eerie atmosphere. The crew paused at the threshold, taking in the sight of the tavern's patrons. Figures cloaked in shadows sat at the tables, their forms indistinct and shimmering slightly, as if only half present in the physical realm. A spectral bartender polished glasses behind the bar, his movements slow and deliberate, as if moving through water. As they entered, the hushed conversation ceased, and all eyes turned toward them, gleaming faintly in the candlelight. "Welcome to the Shrouded Tavern," the bartender's voice boomed, breaking the silence, rich and resonant, as if coming from deep within the earth. "What brings you to this forgotten place?" Eldric stepped forward, the map in hand. "We've come for the relic known to be hidden here," he announced boldly, his voice steady despite the eerie atmosphere. The room felt colder at the mention of the relic, and a tense anticipation filled the air. The spectral figures at the tables seemed to lean closer, and the bartender nodded solemnly. "To seek the relic is to seek the secrets of the forest itself," he intoned. "But knowledge requires sacrifice. To earn the relic, you must first share your truest tales, for stories are the currency in this place." One by one, Eldric and his thieves took their turns at the center of the room, each sharing a story of their past. A tale of lost love, a tale of redemption, a tale of betrayal. Each story seemed to feed the tavern, its candles burning brighter with each word spoken, the air growing warmer, the patrons nodding in appreciation or shaking their heads in sympathy. Finally, as the last tale was told, the bartender smiled, his form becoming more solid, more present. "You have paid well," he said, moving to a section of the floor behind the bar. He lifted a floorboard to reveal a small, iron-bound chest. "The relic is yours, earned by the power of your stories." Eldric stepped forward to take the chest, feeling the weight of their journey in his hands. Inside, the relic, a small crystal vial containing a swirling, luminescent liquid, promised to be the key to untold secrets. As they left the tavern, the forest seemed to sigh around them, a sound of release and contentment, as if it had been waiting just for them to discover its deepest mysteries.